So this is the case, okay? It's a bilateral valgus deformity. I'm sorry, Dr. Allen, if we make some noise in your OR. And the deformity is more severe on the left side, but the patient is more symptomatic on the right side. So according to the patient and the surgical equip of Dr. Kauser, we decided to replace the right side, the less deformed one, unfortunately for you, because maybe the left was more interesting, but it's still, can you go on the template, please, with a larger view? Puoi andare su una visione più larga qui accanto? Bisogna muoversi qua in tutte le... Ok, esci fuori, fagli vedere questo. No, questo, questo. Facciamo... We have done a pre-op planning. Tutto devo vedere, tutto. Tutto, bene. We have done a pre-op planning in order to assess the degree of deformity. Left side is 17 degrees, right side is 10 degrees. And we go to see the relationship, mi stringi per favore, the relationship between anatomical and mechanical axis, which is 6 degrees. That means that in this case, we don't have a valgus deformity on the diaphyseal femur. So it's 6 degrees. And as you can see, these red points, stringere ancora di più sull'articolazione, these red points means the place where the anatomic axis is coming out the metaphysis, so that means is my entry point, as you know, is a little bit more medial in the valgus deformity than usual. Then the red arrows are showing the kind of gap I'm going to see, the gaps I'm expecting, so these will be a little larger medial, a little tighter lateral, and looking this asymmetry, I may expect the amount of release I have to do, which in this case is supposed to be not too much. So if you go on the other views, please, we can see the 1-to-1 ratio picture that is helpful for my sizing. This helps the nurse cutting down the instruments on the table. Can you go on the other film, please? And this is the templating with the sizing and the expected resection. So what I'm doing now is looking for the most prominent and the less prominent condyles, because when we go inside the canal with the instrument and we touch the femur, the medial femur first, scusa, questa, the medial femur first, that means we are in the right direction. If I touch the lateral condyle first, I have a wrong entry point in the canal. So this is my visual feedback. I have to touch the medial femur first because it's the most prominent condyle, and my resection will be more generous medial than lateral. I will do standard resection because this patient has a slight flexion contracture. My expected size are D, but in case I need to balance the flexion gap, which is important in the valgus deformity, I tend to upsize it to an E, and I may benefit from a gender, because the gender has the same mediolateral dimension of a D, a E, and the tibia will be a 3, because my neck size, which is a 4, is increasing only posterior. That means troubles in rotations. So I will stay with a 3. And finally, on the lateral film, I do, like Dr. Dallen, I plan the entry point on the sagittal view because it's very easy to choose a low entry point and have a flexion deformity of your femur. So I choose the entry point in relationship to the Blumensat line, as you can see here in the dotted line. And finally, this is a must in every OR. What? This is a must to have a merchant view. I see too many operative rooms undergoing total knees without having a merchant view. It's not acceptable. You need a patellar view in order to plan what you are going to do together with the symptoms of the patient. I'm coming from a school that tends to resurface the patella, so I probably will resurface the patella even if the clinical radiographical appearance is decent, but this is an osteoporotic lady with a valgus deformity, tendency to a slight maltracking. That means I lower my threshold to resurface the patella. Thank you. This is the plan, as I told you. Usually, if you have a valgus diaphysis, your entry point is more medial than usual. You have to take into account this. Then watch the most prominent and the less prominent condyle, and usually in this type of deformity, The medial condyle is the more prominent, while in the valgus is different. Then we have to know that what we are going to do is different in extension and flexion, because we have the iliotibial band, the posterolateral capsule, and the LCL, which are stabilizer in extension, while LCL plus popliteus in flexion. And we have to remember that the valgus knee in extension is deformed, of course, but most of the time the deformity reduces up to neutral, as you can see in this case and in our case, in flexion. And what we have to take into account also that is often associated to a planus valgus deformity of the foot, which is increasing the abduction moment of the knee. So we have to fight against this foot when the patient is walking. Then we have the femoral rotation issues because we have an hypoplastic posterolateral condyle. We have to take into account these also because I'm going to use an anterior reference instrument, as you know, coming from the next gen. And when we do with these anterior reference instruments and external rotation, which is on average, let's say 3 degrees in a varus knee, because we use a central pivot, we do the external rotation, as you can see in the animation, at the expenses of the posteromedial femoral condyle. That means we can create more space medial in flexion, and the medial collateral ligament is already elongated. So we don't want to create this laxity in flexion. So I'm modifying the technique, as you can see here, using a medial pivot with some tricks that you will see later, and I'm switching to an anterior reference to a posterior reference, like we are accustomed to do in many CR knee. I'm using a PS knee. So we will give to this knee probably between 3 and 5 degrees according to the landmarks of external rotation, but our pivot will be mainly medial, so we don't cut more medial condyle posteriorly. Then we will have a tight space lateral, and we will do, if we need, some release with a pie crusting technique, which now we published with the school of Professor Aglietti. And if the deformity was bigger, our threshold to use an unstemmed semi-constrained CCK will be low. Thank you.
On a three.
On the lateral side, we have an easier life because the... Tieni questo? Sì. Ok, mi dai... I was exposing the epicondyles and the white side line as reference because I was waiting for the line. And now I'm palpating the lateral epicondyle, which is lower. Here, it's a point, so you can feel it where the LCL is inserting. So... gli dai un nastro anche a lui.
State sentendo Baldini che parla?
Sì.
Yes, I will show you. Non
perfetto.
So, I'm doing a limited parapatellar approach in this valgus knee. As you can see also in the slide, in flexion, I have partial reduction of the deformity. So, this is almost neutral axis, like most of the valgus knees. This is the sulcus line, which is not the white side line. This is the white side line, the deeper point of the trochlea, and the mid part in flexion of the two condyles here, which runs on the border of the PCL. So this is the white side line. Here I exposed before the ridge of the medial epicondyle. This is the sulcus where the deep MCL is attaching, and you can transmit in front of the knee this point, which is here approximately. And the lateral epicondyle, we did already, it's a point, and it's the insertion of the LCL and corresponds here. So we can go further. Because this is a valgus deformity, I do the femur first, Bucare. I do the femur first because if I cut the tibia, I want to expose the tibia, I need to peel off most of the MCL, and I don't want to do this because the MCL is already slacked. I cannot benefit the exposure of a varus knee here because if I do that, I create medial laxity. I do the femur first, remove the posterior condyle first, and then it will create space inflection, which will be a safe exposure for the tibia. So I pound the center directly to the medial condyle. As you can see here, there is a sulcus between the patellofemoral and the tibiofemoral joint. And as described by Ranawat, this sulcus here, Pinza, this sulcus here is the reference for the level of the entry point, like we marked in our picture before. Now I go toward the medial condyle, and then I go in the valgus direction as desired. As you can see, I'm going on and off with the reamer because I'm following the canal. I'm not imposing the direction. Now, as we planned, I calculate 1 degree less than we said. I will give 5 degrees in this case. If the valgus was more severe, I would give 4. In my varus knee, on average, is 6, but everything is planned on the long film. Then I go and I will look if I touch the medial condyle first, and I do that, and this is what I measure on the template, so I'm happy. This is my visual feedback. Then we go for our good landmark, which is I trust in the anterosuperior iliac spine up there, and this is the common rule which tells you that, can I feel it? Which tell us that we need to be 2 finger breadths medial. As you can see, I'm not too, mettile due dita, I'm not too, no, mettile verso la testa, girate verso la testa. I'm less than 2, I'm 1, 1.5, because I'm undercorrecting a little bit, because this is a valgus. So I'm happy, and now I'm putting the distal femoral resecting guide, which is this, with a 3-degree angle, because I'm cutting the distal femur at 3 degrees, because this gives me more play in sizing of the component and avoiding the notch anteriorly. Pin normali, a mano, bene. Ok, martello, aspetta, altro pin. I don't use headless pins because they are less stable, and respecting the plan, mi tocchi il pin col dito, toccalo, bravo, toccalo. Respecting the plan, I won't do the recut. And then I have a dedicated instrument in case I need to do the recut. Sega, larga. Okay, now we saw with the instrument in situ, because my guide will be much more stable even if I bend my hand. So this is just the start. Vai giù. Fammi vedere una cosa, scusa.
Stai nascondendo un po'.
Sì. Ok. Mi fai togliere questo pin. Ok. Rimettili tu perché si era elevato. Aspetta, tieni. Scusa. Vai. Aspetta un attimo, ok, scusa, ok, attenti alla pelle, vai, ok, ancora nascondo, ok, devo stare, basta, sega, con la... Okay. Then as soon as it's impossible to continue, we remove this and we continue the resection.
Se avete, if you have some question, please.
Al momento no, grazie.
Excuse me?
Of course, when you do a valgus deformity, you have to keep in mind that the medial condyle is always soft and osteopenic, and the lateral condyle is harder, much harder, lower, much harder. Now we have done the distal femoral resection, and we remove the condyle as planned. And I'll tell you it's as planned because they come not together, so I mean that I'm at the trochlear level.
C'è una domanda
then
dalla...
I check if my...
Possiamo fare una domanda?
Ok. Sì,
sì, sì.
Andrea, sono Vincenzo. Hai fatto 93 gradi di inclinazione del taglio distale. La mascherina...
Dobbiamo parlare in italiano o in inglese?
Stanno parlando tutti in italiano. If you want, I speak in English.
Va bene.
The distal cut of the femur is done about 93 degrees of flexion. And the jig of the distal cut, you paid attention to external rotate the jig or?
Yes. I don't sit on the medial condyle fully. Yeah, I pay attention to this. I don't want to sit on the medial condyle. Now, yes, it's important because when you have some degrees inflection, is like in the tibia, you may affect the axis. Then what I do, mi dai la lama libera da de 15, cioè il manico del 15, il manico. So what I do now, I'm using this instrument, which is a sizing instrument, which is between D and E, closer to E, and is giving me the options of rotation, 3 degrees, 7, 5, as you can see. Now, I want to switch from anterior reference to posterior reference, otherwise, when I do the rotational adjustment, I can cut, mi levi la lama, I can cut too much bone on the medial side. And in order to do this, I will fit here this, which is 2 millimeter thick. I will fit at the footprint of the instrument here. Okay, tiamalo lo strumento, tiamalo giù. Okay. Okay, I will repeat, and I will show you later on with the mask because it will be easier. Dammi ora i due pin. So I don't want to fully refer on the anterior reference, which is misleading in a valgus deformity. Anterior reference may lead to a bigger flexion space here, and particularly sacrifice the medial posterior condyle because I'm doing more rotation than we used to do for the varus deformity. So I'm setting 3 degrees, which is the minimum amount of rotation you can give in a standard varus knee. Probably in this knee, I need more rotation. I will check the epicondyles later now. Now I will set 3. I'm between E and D, closer to E. I don't know if you can appreciate this. And now I give 3 degrees from the posterior condyle, which usually in a valgus knee is not enough.
Giancarlo.
Then I switch.
Dimmi.
Una comunicazione di servizio. Hanno esteso il collegamento col satellite ancora per mezz'ora, quindi si può andare tranquilli.
Okay. Non c'è problema, ma fra mezz'ora qui abbiamo finito, chiuso le ferite e stiamo da voi.
Perfetto.
Tira forte, lascia. Ok, so what I have here is the medial epicondyle center. Here is the lateral epicondyle. Mi dai una scalpello, una lima, quella là. I can judge if I'm parallel to the line which give me 3 degrees, and I am. As you can see, mi dai uno osteotomo senza manico. Okay, as you can see, I am parallel, okay? These two lines are parallel, non pigiare tanto. These two lines are parallel. I don't know if you can appreciate. So I don't add any more degrees, but in case I have to add degrees in order not to resect more medial posterior condyle, I would remove the lateral pin and go down only lateral. I will keep it on the medial fixed, so I don't remove more bone medial, okay? Because I don't pivot in the center, but I pivot on the medial pin. Mi dai la D? Faccio vedere la differenza. So this is a E, and the gold one is already big like the gender. I am overhanging mediolateral with the E. So I will see how much bone I'm removing with the D. The D seems to fit well mediolaterally. I don't have to choose the mediolateral direction now. I will choose it later. And with the D, I see that I can remove too much posterior condyle, as you can see. So, because I'm removing too much posterior condyle now, mi dai una pinza? I will move the mask down 1.5 millimeters. And this was possible with the old epicondylar instrument. It's no more possible with this, but I do it handmade because I did the 3-degree angle in my distal femur, so even if I go posterior, I won't notch anterior.
But why you have changed from the other instrument?
Because these are You will see I have a mix instruments. This is the epicondylar instrument, the old one. This is the old one. So I have a mixed instrument because to me, with the MIS came out also some technology which is not ideal, so I'm compromising, and you need to have into mind this.
I am an old man, I'm still using the old instruments.
Yes, I agree. So I remove this, but I have the landmarks because I can see the holes there. Mid I do a contesta. I can see the holes. So, Lascia, I will cover both holes coming down posterior. So I will cover both holes, I will come down, and then I put this, mi dai il martello, batti tu, okay. Medially softer, so it's not moving my mask. Everything you do should be first on the soft side. Batti qua sopra, qua, batti qua, fammi guardare, leva il dito. Good. Okay, I'm happy about that because I have less bone here. And I posteriorized my mask. I don't need to double check because I can see it, that the cut is good, and I go with the saw. Don't leave her on the medial collateral ligament.
May I ask you another question, Baldini? Why you are not using the little tool that touches the posterior part of the condyle?
Because with this instrument I don't have the central slot, so I cannot move it posterior. And I have a visual feedback on the osteochondral junction here. Because as you see, mi dai una pinza, as you see here at the posterior condyle, I don't know if they can see it in the camera, I will show you. If you see here, I have exposed bone here, and usually they are 9 millimeters when you are cutting the junction of the osteochondral junction. Now I'm a little bit more than that, because I'm doing a flex cut which is 2 millimeters more posterior, so it's a visual feedback for me. Okay, now I cut anterior, and there is a trick not to do the notch. Alza qua. There is a trick, mi dai la maschera, la siga più fine. I will show you a trick not to do the notch. Stai senza tirare, solo così. Our retractors should be like barriers, not like retractors. We don't have to pull on tissue, but just to do a barrier. I go with a thinner blade here, and I violate the medial side first. Then I start the lateral side, but I don't finish the lateral side because the femur is like this, and as soon as I touch the cortex, it may drive me inside. So I don't want to be slave of the mask, and I will remove the mask now, and I finish the cut freehand, monta la più grande, la lama più grande. So as you can see, I'm mixing the technique. I'm not using this as a 4-in-1, but I'm doing the two classic gaps, because at the end I will use a guide which allows me to do the box but also the chamfers. So I don't pay the price of finishing the femur now. I can do gap balancing first. This is a mixed technique of measure resection and gap technique. So I can go inside the bone, lower my hand so I don't violate the anterolateral cortex because I'm not slave of the guide, and I can finish it, okay? Is a some cheat. Mi dai la ossivora? Ok, scalpello poi, possibilmente curvo.
I don't know if you have some question?
I want to show you a visual feedback which is the grand piano sign.
No, mi dai per la adesso prima? No.
I will show you the grand piano sign which is this. So, this grand piano here, which as you can see the shape is like the shape of the grand piano, is showing that I resected more the lateral column than the medial column. I don't know if you can see it. Yes. So this is the piano sign telling you that we are correct in external rotation. Tieni. Now I will move out the posterior condyles, lateral and medial. Okay. And now my MCL is safe. Because I have detension of the joint, I can move freely the tibia, I won't damage the MCL. Okay, the piano sign is this. You will see in extension better now. apri l'altro. I draw the piano here. I don't know if you can see it. Probably yes now. Okay, you can zoom inside. I will stop a little bit to show you. So, this drawing is a piano shape. That means that I removed more from the lateral side and less from the medial side. That means external rotation of the resection. If you have a symmetric, they call butterfly sign, which is like a butterfly, that means you remove the same amount, medial and lateral, that means neutral rotation or internal. So we now move to the tibia, and in order, mi dai la codivilla? In order to keep the MCL, which is our aim here, I will use this instrument and a thin bent Oman. Oman, mi tieni il piede, cambia mano. Okay, a thin bent Oman here, superficial, with this direction. So it's like a barrier against the MCL. Tieni questo, dammi. Bene. Now I remove a little bit more of fat pad because it's on the way. Mi dai la lure, bene. E guida di taglio tibiale, please. Of course, I cannot enjoy the so-called Ransal maneuver. Ransal maneuver is like you saw with Allen. So you put all the tibia forward and you see everything. But if I do that, I will peel my MCL. Okay, no, di là prima. So this is the jig, it's an old jig, but I like this jig because it's symmetric. What means symmetric? Is that it's not left and right, because left and right is misleading for you with the alignment, because I need to know where the center of my instrument goes, and it should go where my planning go, which is a little bit toward the medial spine on the tibia, and down on the ankle is the classic center of the talus, which is a little medial than the center of the malleoli. Then I will choose my position up here, which is now Kyodo. I cut it down, this instrument, because it can engage here even in a small approach. Then I fix it only one dimension. I can fix varus valgus now, and I like it because I go far from the joint. I need to go a little bit more medial. I go far from the joint. You need to escape from the knee to have a better view, and then you can feel your distal third of the tibia, all the landmarks, the classic one, the second malleoli, and all this stuff. Then I separate these, mi tieni piede, varus valgus, posterior slope, which is neutral. That means I'm giving 7 degrees with this jig, because I'm not adding or removing anything based on the template before. And now, separate, I can judge the deepness of resection, which should be 10 millimeter from the medial condyle, which is the safe side, the good side. So now I'm 10. My plan showed me that I will remove more than 2 millimeters on the lateral side because the deformity is not a major one here. I fix on the same side and then we can go with the saw. Siga. So now I'm ready for the resection. I give a look with my saw before cutting if I'm on the right way. Cut first the soft condyle and create a barrier toward my blade. Okay, now I remove it like this because they are on the same side, so I can do that. And then I will expose a little bit more. Tieni questo, mi dai lo scalpello. Sì, retto, e poi mi dai una codivilla anche a me. Okay, as you see, I'm very gentle here close to the MCL. And then you can take this to spin the place, to spin the piece in this direction. As soon as you remove the posterior horn of the meniscus, the PCL, and the adhesions here. Ruota al piede, ruota al piede, estremo, piano, piano, piano. Ok. Non tengono queste codivilla. No, va bene, ormai faccio così. Aspetta. Mi dai lo scalpello? Okay, so the piece is more generous on the medial side, less on the lateral because of the correction, but like the template. Now I can check visually the distal space I have, which is trapezoidal. It's opening more medial and less lateral. We will go later. I will finish to work in the flexion space with a spreader. I have this type of spreader, which is designed by Lombardi, and they are calibrated. As you can see here, I can see the millimeter. This gives me the opening of the gap, and I can see on the border the millimeter. So I know when I'm 20, I'm fine, because this is the space of the prosthesis, plus 2 because it's a flex. So now I'm opening, I'm watching the lateral side, which is 18. That means, reggi questo così. That means that I have to open the space 2 millimeter with the lateral release. Now I'm going to the medial, la pinza da menisco. Now I'm going to the medial meniscus because I can see the entire meniscus, so I can remove it in once. And because my colleague is pulling the capsule here, so, and you see the intimate adhesion between the meniscus and the capsule. And if I don't do it now, I can sacrifice my MCL. So this is preserving the MCL. Okay? If you want to use an unconstrained knee, throughout the procedure in the valgus, you have to preserve the MCL, throughout the entire procedure. So I remove now the entire meniscus because I can see it. I finish to remove my PCL, and then I work in the back of the knee. I already removed the lateral meniscus. There is only a scar here. Most of the PCL will come out also with the box cut. Ok, scalpello curvo, lure e cucchiaio. Now with the curved osteotome we will work in the back for the posterior osteophyte. I remove the bone martello. Piano perché ti va via questo. Ok, I remove the bone postero at the junction between the bone and the cartilage, then I lever it with the, mi dai quelle cucchiaio? I lever it with the, with this, I lever it out, and then I remove with the, mi dai l'ossivora, lasciamole qui, ossivora, lasciami anche lo scalpello. I remove this, okay, and then I can move on the lateral side. The meniscus is out already, so I can give a look to the medial joint space. As you can see now is 20-21, so is larger than 18, the lateral side, okay? But this is already fine. I want this type of gap. I have to enlarge the lateral. I will go more central, so I have more displacement, like this. Okay, fermo. Mi dai il martello, è qui. And I remove the posterior osteophyte lateral, okay? Then it's done. I remove it now, putting in the center of the joint, like this. And then I kick it out. Okay. I start watching the structure in the lateral side, like the popliteus. Hopefully I can show you later on in extension. I feel with my finger. I have a clean space in the back. That means that the posterior recesses are open again. Now I'm going to do assessment with the other blocks. These are my trial. These are my trial components. I don't use trial components. It's a waste. I use the final component with the trial poly and this as trial. Now I go in flexion and I'm fine medial but tight lateral as expected. And the same should be in extension, probably even more. I'm fine medial so the 10 millimeter can fit, as you can see on the medial side, it can fit. Okay. It can fit, but it won't fit on the lateral side because it's tight. So I will use the spreader in extension as described by John Insel, and we will distract the lateral side. The one colleague will keep tension on his hands. Me lo strizzi progressivo. Progressivo via via taglio le strutture. Aspira, leva questo, nastro. I hope you can see the structures in the back of the knee. And these are the structures. I'll show you. Tieni questo così. Mi dai attenzione alla testa, se no parà. Mi dai una pinza con la. So, here there is a diagonal structure. It's difficult to have a focus here, but you can see a white diagonal structure if you zoom inside, which is the popliteus. I will show you with the tip of my. So the popliteus is a white structure here. You don't see because it's difficult to focus inside. Oh, you can see now. Okay, here is the popliteus. There is this band. Aspirare. It's coming up here and going down there. I want to show you, okay? Mi dai una cosa curva? Una pinza curva? Quella lì, curva, la cocker. Okay?
So, do you have any question?
This is the popliteus. So this is the popliteus coming down in the angle. Can you see it now? Okay, this is. Because this is our landmark for the release. So I will go in this corner here, anterior to the popliteus. This is the posterolateral capsule. Dammi la mappa piccola da 15. If I start here, anterior to the corner of the popliteus, we have a good cameraman. Probably in no meeting they showed the popliteus like this. So this is the popliteus. I'm going anterior with the blade. I will show you the blade here. See, tieni. Let me see. So this is the blade. If you go, è montata male. È montata, lasciala fare. So if you go less than 1 centimeter, you'll not touch the peroneal sciatic nerve. Okay, it's studied. So I start there, strizza. I start there at the joint line level, at the tibia level, and then I move anterior. So this is posterolateral capsule, and then I touch the IT band here anterior. We have the iliotibial tract. Dimmi millimetri, eh. Dimmi millimetri qua, non strizzare. Quant'è? Ok. So it's already 20. I want a little freedom in extension, so I will go up to 21, 22, touching the iliotibial tract, which is the other structure. Strizza. Ok. So it's opening, and I'm touching the iliotibial band only, because I'm anterior, close to the Gerdes tubercle. If I need more release, I go proximal. But now, how much is 22? Quant'è? Eh? Troppo. No, l'hai aperto troppo forte te. La devi aprire piano, capito? 25. So this is 24, 25, which is good for me. Ok, tieni. Now we finish the femur and the job is done. Dammi questo. You can see a double check with the spacer block now, here, with the spacer block. Inflection, you can do a pull-up test, pulling the femur up, and you see there is no opening of the joint, no opening of the joint inflection. You can do the varus valgus test inflection. As you can see here, we have no opening medial, which is mandatory in a valgus knee. No opening medial, same balance lateral, okay? And we have the patella almost in its place. Then we go in extension, paying attention because I didn't do the chamfer, so we go in extension, and I want to see full extension now. If I don't have full extension now, I do a recut now or work on the posterior capsule. So I have good extension, good axis, because I don't have a big concavity here, which means residual valgus. I want to see where the concavity is here, and here is pretty straight. And then I do the stress in extension and see a very slight opening in the medial side, 1 millimeter only, and almost nothing on the lateral side. Good. So we finish the femur now. Mi dai due Oman? I still have to remove the lateral osteophytes, which will give me a little bit more freedom in extension. So additional release. So limited incision technique, you use only two bent Omans like this, very simple, and always in the same position, here in the tibia, and you should enter like this in order not to notch the bone. So you enter like this, you twist it, and you displace the patella. Then you go on the lateral side, close on the condyle to protect the MCL during my resection, now to finish the femur. Mi dai la guida D, abbiamo scelto questa, mi dai due pin. Now there is another little trick I want to show you, and Zimmer will kill me about this, because, so this is mediolateral position, as you can see with the D, as soon as I remove the osteophyte, I will be very precise. This is larger than the gender. The gender is this, less than this prominence, okay? So I can visualize my gender position, which will be all the way lateral up to the corner. Mi fai levare l'osteofita con l'ossivora? Okay. So I remove the osteophyte here, which was not a huge osteophyte, but was present, as we could see on the film. Okay, and then I put this one. Like every MIS guide has problems, because in order to fit in the joint, they reduced everything. So this has not enough metal. And mi dai un pin lungo? When you use regular pins and you go in these holes with not enough metal, you can go in a wrong direction, in a wrong angle, and as soon as you go in the bone, it will displace the guide, and you have to remove it and do it again. So I found a solution using very, very short pin to start with, as you will see. Mi tieni la gamba qualcuno, un po' più piegato, sempre più piegato del blocco. Più piegato del blocco, okay. So I use very short pin, 17 millimeter, and I will pin inside just this, hand with my hands, okay? And okay, so I'm not slave of the pins, and then mi dai un altro pin. Normale, sì, lungo. Battite, martello, battite. Bucare prima. I use less pin as possible, battimi sopra questi un po'. Basta. And I use the drill bit like this as a fixation device. Sega lama larga. Scalpello largo per proteggere, me lo tieni per favore così, seguimi, seguimi piano. So I finish the femur with a large blade because I can engage the slot with a large blade. Ok, ora esci. Pronto a ritornarci, aspetta. No, non importa, non vado fuori dalla maschera, non importa. Rientra. Medial side first and then lateral side, vai laterale. Ok, chiamalo giù con il dito qua, pigiato, leva la mano, ma lo deve fare lui, lascia la gamba, chiami questo, ok. Lama stretta, stai dentro, martello, bene, lama stretta. Vieni, mi dai la coltellare ora? Ok, leva tutto. This is a freehand cut of the trochlear cut, which has the same angle here of the chamfer, so I need to go 2 millimeters down only and do this. I do it freehand, otherwise I would need another instrument. Fatto, levali, dammi. Scalpello, bene, mi dai la lure, non levate i pezzi, scalpello, ok, non so se ci sono delle domande.
Do you have any question? Everybody sleeping.
No, sono svegli, ma nessuna domanda particolare.
Ah, no.
Mi dai il battitore dei pin? Battitore dei pin come battitore del tappo. Ossivora, ce l'ho qua, via questo, non so se sono sulla via. With the MIS guide, another problem is that you always don't finish all the resection because they are limited guide, and you have to trim the bone with your ronger all the time. Tieni questo, mi dai la guida tibiale. So we have finished the femur with the chamfer, and now we will go on the tibial side. Tieni, abbassare il letto. Now I can pull the tibia forward a little bit. I have a second, I have a second bump on the table which fix my, my flexion at 100, I'm full flexion practically. Now I have the tibia and I can see the tibia, con il gomito devi pigiare sul femore così. I don't use posterior omen because the assistant with the elbows is pushing the femur and exposing the tibia in my face. I use even size holds only in female, like 3-5, because the odd size, because the even size are increasing posteriorly only. Mi dà una 4, vi faccio vedere la differenza. So if I use the 4, for example, the feet, mi dai la lure? Stai un po' così, basta. Ok, spingi leggermente sul femore, bene. As soon as he's putting pressure with the elbow here, he's displacing forward the tibia, so we are limiting this for the MCL, but he will show me the tibial surface doing this. Then I have all the tibial platform here, and I will show you my rotational landmark. Mi dai la penna? My rotational landmark is only in part the third of the tuberosity, because it's a difficult point to see. We did an MRI study in full extension in more than 100 knees, and we published now, and we presented at the Academy, that the anterior tibial cortex, this part, dammene una nuova, this part is the most reliable landmark. And this concept is coming from the bone morphing technology of the navigation. This is the anterior tibial curve here. And this part should match, tieni questo, with my component. So my component will fit the size of the lateral condyle. Mi dai una pinza da coagulo? Grazie. So I will fit in the lateral border. So this is my limit, see, with the bowie tip. And then I touch it with my component, and I want a curved on curved match between the symmetric tibia, which is this, with the anterior cortex. So this curved on curved reference is telling you the right direction. If I want to be here because I want to touch the cortex posteromedial, I will be internally rotated. If I will be like this with exposed bone anterolaterally, I will be too much externally rotated. So the best landmark is curved on curved matching between your component and the anterior tibial curve, and this correlates with the tubercle. Plus is a bone morphing technology because it's a big curve and you are more accurate between different observer. Piccolo pin, montato. Okay. So I fit the small pin because it's not displacing my guide. Okay, and I will finish now. Dammi da finire. Buco diretto. You don't need many pins. If you are accurate, you need as less as possible pins. Dammi da bucare. Reverse, sopra. I do reverse because I want to compress the bone, not to remove the bone. So I'm going reverse and not at the point, a little less. Otherwise, the cement will go down. And then I finish it with the final jig, staying curve on curve. So this is the finishing jig. Aspetta. Okay. Se no rompo l'acqua, capito? Okay, dammi. Sono nella direzione giusta dietro? Okay, good. Piega leggermente, basta, pigia. Dammi due codivilla che facciamo la rotula. I will do the patella. I know that in Italy most of the surgeons don't do that, but I think in the valgus knee with osteoporosis like this lady, even if it's a good-looking patella, I think it's a possible source of pain, and I don't look the way it appears because it's not evidence-based. You don't have to replace or not replace the patella, tira questo, based on this appearance. Mi dai la lure? Pronti a partire col cemento? Mi dai ora prima il calibro. We will do a freehand resection and I will show you two different techniques of resection. So
First you should judge, è una 29, you should judge the thickness, capito? Which is 20, non partire finché non te lo dico, 22, non partire finché non te lo dico il cemento. Sega? Sega? Sei già partita, vero?
No.
Ah, va bene. So, the first technique, devi tirare giù forte, tira giù forte con questo, lui su. First technique is Lombardi technique, which violate here between the chondral, the osteochondral junction coming precise here on the lateral facet. The other technique is the Bob Wood technique, sitting on the nose of the patella, but the nose of the patella here is non-existing, so I cannot sit on anything. So I prefer here the Lombardi technique with my finger in the anterior surface, because the anterior surface is the reliable landmark, is a non-deformed surface. So my blade should be in parallel to my finger here. This is my guide. And you should come here at the cartilage junction, see? So you remove more medial facet and less lateral facet. Ok, dammi la lure, puoi mescolare, apri le taglie, ce l'hai? D, gender, ok. Lombardi studied that when you remove the patella and you stay flush with the tendons, you have at least 13 mm bone left. So if you have 13, now... Mi dai il buco da fare la rotola 29, te l'ho chiesto prima, e mi dai da bucare? Ci vuole questo, 29, veloce. No, ti ho detto 29 ora, te l'ho detto prima da curare. Vieni, dammi il martello. 29, I'm fitting the medial facet, and here because the patella is oval, there will be some bone exposed, so as medial as possible, bucare. Mescola al cemento. And then I touch with this for a reference of the overhanging facet. Ascia. Okay. Good. Tieni, sega. So I peel the retinaculum and I cut the facet overhanging with a saw blade.
Domande in aula.
So this is a chamfer.
C'è più nessuno in aula?
Tantissimi, ma le domande?
C'è più nessuno. Vabbè, non importa, eh?
Sì, un attimo la domanda, Vincenzo Madonna.
Andrea, you told us in the medial lateral inclination of the saw blade, but in distal proximal inclination, what about?
The tendons, your reference is the tendons. You need to be flush with the tendons, both the patella and the quadriceps. Okay, good. I want to see some recurvatum at the end with the chamfer done, because I'm not doing the trial component reduction. Okay, lavare. Mi dai lo spreader? Vai, aspetta. Laviamo con lo spreader in estensione. Bene. Okay. Mi cambi i guanti? Bene, okay. Cosa c'è? Che problema è? Dimmi. Eh? Che protesi è questa? La E? No. Eh? D, cavolo, dai. Dai, sta attento a quello. Sì. No, non lo volevo sulla tibia, te l'avevo detto. Non lo voglio sulla tibia. Lo voglio solo dietro al femore, basta. Lascialo lì. Mettilo solo dietro al femore, vai a aprirlo. Basta, ok, basta, cambiatevi i guanti, dacci i guanti. No, tanti 8 per tutti, dammi a me. Telino pulito. Mi dai il cemento. Cambia i guanti a tutti, dai.
E tu protesizzi tutte le rotole?
No, tendo a protesizzare per la maggior parte le donne. Tira, fregate, ti fregate, fregate, tira. Tendo a protesizzare per la maggior parte le donne osteoporotiche e soprattutto se la donna ha del dolore anteriore. Questa paziente, come tutti i valghi, aveva dolore laterale ma anche anteriore abbastanza. Quindi se il paziente ha nell'anamnesi dolore anteriore, ha osteoporosi, sesso femminile, la mia soglia è bassa nel protesizzare. Patella, veloce? Veloce, perché questo cemento è caldo qui, tira. Dammi la rotula, non c'è tempo. Dammi da stringere, dammi due Oman e pinze da coagulo. Ma qui non va bene, perché avete un po' dormito ora. Dammi il... dammi un pomodoro di cemento. Sì. Lascia, leva la codivilla. Non uso il patella squeezer, mi dà solo noia perché non everto la rotula. Dammi gli Oman, due Oman, pinzine, dai. Bene.
Una comunicazione per tutti. Bene, questa sera c'è una cena offerta dalla Maite Dupuy. Chi vuole partecipare può passare in segreteria e avrà le informazioni corrette.
Basta, questo, dietro, tieni, piano. Ok, tira in avanti senza slittare sulla rotula, aspirare dentro. Dammi il pomodoro veloce. Dammi ora la tibia. Cemento anche il canale, però cerco di non lasciare cemento sul fondo.
Giancarlo, fra 5 minuti dobbiamo chiudere il collegamento col satellite.
Bene, tra 5
minuti. Ringraziamo il Dio.
Battere, martello. Pinzina anche a me.
Dammi. Baldini, since we are closing with the satellite, I would like to know if you have some other advice to give us from this moment until the end.
Dammi il cemento per la femore. Veloce, dammi il femore. Senti com'è caldo che sta, capito? Bene, dammi. Non voglio fare la cementazione. I don't want to cement with the cement too much daggy, too much... Heart, mi dai ora il battitore. I want this advice. Ho il mio blu, ragazzi, attenti. Ho il mio blu. I have this which holds the femur in extension. Altro battitore. Dammi ora, per favore, dammi il battitore, perché me l'hanno dato duro. Dammi questo, bene, ok. Va bene comunque. Ok, vai. Mi dai ora il, no, qui sei nell'osso, Dammi la plastica, voglio ridurla in estensione. Bene, ok. Si leva dopo, voglio dargli la compressione. Adesso, lascia. Ok. Dammi l'Oman. Lascia. Ok, no, va bene. Leva. Lascia a me, no. Ok. Lascia un attimo. Ok, basta. Ora levare il cemento. Dammi le pinze, dai. Bene. Levatelo sul femore, io lo levo da qui. Ok. Ora si leva in estensione in alto. Bene. Ok. Qui pigia poco perché entri dentro l'osso, è porotico, capito? Ok, basta. Puoi mollare il laccio, per favore. Molla il laccio. Pigia poco, pigia perché stende già. Bene. Quando si molla il laccio, si fa la coagulazione mediale, perché il sangue viene da mediale. Basta, vieni. Vai, tocca. anche. Mi dai i guanti? Okay. No, lo tengo in compressione per la rotulosion. Altro guanto. Telino pulito. Apri il 10. Poi mi dai il calibro. Mi dai il calibro. Aspetta, alza il piede al massimo. Bene, ok. Attenzione perché se questo tira ustiona. Bene, ok. Basta. Okay, lascialo così, lascialo. Okay. Ora comincia a essere tirato, bene, stabilità, buono, buono. Aspetta. Lascia, stabilità in flessione, non clicca, vedi mediale. Va bene. Ok, scorrimento rotuleo centrato anche se non tiriamo. Mi dai la pinzina? È un Oman, non è tirato ancora, quindi aspettiamo a fare troppe manovre. Mi dai la plastica finale veloce con una garza prima? Oman, tieni, garza, grazie. Oman, questa è la mia prova, componenti finale e plastica di prova. Puoi farlo se sei sicuro di non dover fare un recat alla fine. Mi dai da levare questo stofita? O si vorrà? Mi dai la plastica? Sta tirando. Ok. Nastro a lui. Nastro a lui, garza. Bene, piega piano, bene, perché sennò ti sputa fuori il femore. Bene, ok, lascialo così, mi dai la pinza, sbandata mediale sempre, ok. Ecco. No, no, aspetta, devi venire, qua e uscire sotto, capito? Sennò la sfili via la rotola. Ok, mi dai un drenaggio, non so se lo mettete, ma io lo uso. Lavare prima, laviamo. Ah, mi sembra l'estensione completa e stabile sia in estensione che in flessione. Pinza da coagulo, basta, okay, perfetto. Così. Tocca. Mi dai il drenaggio? No, voglio coagulare adesso, aspetta, perché sennò... Mi dai una... Sanguina niente, no. Mi dai una garza pulita, bene. Quella l'apro, bene. Non sanguina.
Qui Giancarlo, chiudiamo l'ora del collegamento.
Giancarlo è già a cena.
Ok, benissimo allora. Ciao, arrivederci.
Arrivederci. Ciao, grazie.
Ci vediamo poi a cena allora per la discussione. Tutti invitati, come dico, eh. Passate alla reception a prendere il voucher.
Non so se ci sono domande, ma... mi dai da chiudere, dammi un moschito per il basso, dammi prima l'etibon non riassorbibile che ho rubato.